Computer keyboards designed for Chrome OS have unconventional layouts and special keys that may not work properly if you try and use them with Windows. In this video, I show you how to use free software to analyse and remap your Chrome OS keyboard to unlock its potential on a Windows PC. So let's go! This Chromebox keyboard came bundled with an Acer Chromebox. If you decide to remove Chrome OS from your Chromebox or Chromebook and install Windows or Linux on it instead, you'll probably find that some of the keys either don't work or behave strangely. There's a remedy for that though, so don't toss it out. Using the 30-day free trial version of the Windows application PassMark Keyboard Test, I was able to tap away on this keyboard's keys and see how the keys were behaving. Here's what I discovered. The row of keys across the top of the keyboard are actually function keys from F1 through F10. The next key to the right has a padlock icon on it, but no assigned function in Windows. We'll remap this key later. The right shift key is hardwired to act as a duplicate left shift. While this won't affect typing, games won't be able to tell the difference between your left and right shift keys. The right alt key sends both right alt and left control signals simultaneously. This key is best avoided. The search key, the magnifying glass, is located where caps lock usually sits. In Windows, it functions as the Windows key. The numeric keypad only works as arrows for now, but assigning a numlock key will fix that. These quirks are probably standard across Chromebox and Chromebook keyboards, but I haven't tested enough to know for sure. If you're planning on de-googling a Chromebook and using the built-in keyboard, I recommend testing it yourself after you've installed Windows on it. There's a download link for keyboard test in the video description. Once you've made sense of how keys behave on your Chromebox or Chromebook keyboard, you can decide how to remap keys using the free Windows program KeyTweak. I recommend using KeyTweak's half-teach function. You simply press the key that you want to remap, then select the keystroke you wish to send from the pull-down menu. I decided to assign the numlock function to my unused padlock key. This will allow the keypad to switch between sending numbers and arrow commands. KeyTweak won't disable a key entirely, so I left the right alt key and right shift key as they are. I decided to keep the function keys and Windows key and just relabel them. Now before you apply your changes, you might like to save your new key mapping. Here's my keyboard layout after relabeling and assigning a numlock key. You can download my setting file from the link in the video description. When you apply your changes, they're written to the Windows registry, which means Windows will keep the settings until you choose to rewrite them again. Keep in mind that if you plug in a normal computer keyboard, the changes will remain in place. That won't be a problem with my settings though, as all I did was assign an extra numlock key. If you make more radical changes, then decide to swap back to a conventional keyboard, use KeyTweak to restore the Windows default settings here. So that's it, now you can reboot your computer and your Chrome keyboard will be ready to go with keys remapped with your new settings. Better than that, you've saved it from becoming another lump of e-waste or worse, landfill. If you've found something weird in a Chrome OS keyboard or you find a clever or creative use for keyboard remapping, let me know in the comments. As always, please like, comment, and subscribe for more Danimation's digital media tips. And as always, thanks for watching.